How's it going, peeps? Welcome back to Viva La Coin. I am Joe. I will be your host for today's episode as we dive in and look at the different type of wallets that you can store your cryptocurrency in, why it's important to have a hard wallet, which is essentially keeping your cryptocurrency completely offline and protected, and ultimately a couple do's and don'ts when it comes to locking up your crypto to make sure that you aren't scammed, hacked, or taken advantage of by the millions of people that will evidently try to do this, because no one can just be successful on their own. They have to fucking cheat their way to the top. So we're not going to allow that to happen to us. But aside from that, if you find this useful, if you know someone that has just been almost paralyzed in fear trying to wrap their head around the idea of a hard wallet and they're not sure where to begin, share this video with them. And ultimately, I think that they're going to feel a little bit more comfortable with the concept behind it. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. I would be honored to have you here on our daily episodes diving into the different aspects of crypto. And on that note, we are just going to jump in hot. So, first and foremost, we want to discuss what different types of wallets exist in cryptocurrency. Most people refer to them as Bitcoin wallets just because for the longest time, Bitcoin was predominantly the cryptocurrency that you would want to protect the most and keep stored offline. But just know that Bitcoin wallet is interchangeable with hard wallet or soft wallet. And I'm going to break down the differences between them. Now, ultimately, if you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below, and I'm happy to respond to any additional outlying items that maybe we didn't clarify or that you would like to know. But let's talk a little bit about what a cryptocurrency wallet is. So when you talk about ownership, it is not about you purchasing Bitcoin. It is not about you, even if you go on Robinhood and you buy $5,000 worth of Bitcoin. You don't own Bitcoin at that point because they haven't sent you the Bitcoin. You just have a paper note that says you own Bitcoin. So when you purchase Bitcoin, I clarified in one of my earlier videos that you want to make sure that you purchase it from an exchange or a decentralized exchange that will allow you to own that cryptocurrency. So if you use, let's say, Coinbase, Binance, Voyager, Kraken, any of the typical exchanges that we've covered so far, you will own the cryptocurrency that you have on there. You will have the right to sell it, buy it, transfer it, convert it, whatever you may want to do with it, you own it and it is yours. However, we get into very dicey territory there because if it is a centralized exchange, if it is somewhere that your private keys are not distinctly owned by you and they are held within an exchange, your cryptocurrency could be at risk. So let's look at the different types of wallets and why you would possibly have your crypto at risk if you don't take advantage of this. So basically, there are four types of wallets. So you have online wallets, and an online Bitcoin wallet is a website or app that stores your Bitcoin keys on a server. And when they say keys, those are your private keys that associate you with your Bitcoin. When you purchase Bitcoin, there are private keys associated with it. And if you don't own those keys and hold them privately yourself, then they are in someone else's hands. And it would be the same as you keeping your money, let's say, at the bank. Yes, your money's at the bank, but technically you're not holding it. You don't have it in your custody. It is in their custody. So that would be, let's say, your Coinbase exchange app, right? You may purchase Bitcoin and it's in a wallet, but it is wholly online. Whether it's their online website or their Coinbase app, your Bitcoin is still on their online servers. And let's say there's a very rare chance of this happening with some of the larger exchanges, but it has happened in the past to different exchanges. If there is a massive hack, or there's something that occurs at that centralized exchange, then your Bitcoin could be at risk, as well as your private keys and everything else that you have on there. So not the best place to store it long term. So then there's another step. So then you have software wallets. So software wallets are applications you install on your computer or smartphone. They store your Bitcoin private keys on your local device or flash drive. And that would be more or less what I showed you when I was pulling up. Coinbase has a specific wallet that is not the app itself. It isn't the exchange itself. It's just a software that you download. You can transfer your cryptocurrency onto that wallet. Now, yes, it is more secure, but the problem is you are still open to certain phishing attacks. So although no one is able to steal it if they hack into Coinbase as an exchange, if you click into an email that has malware, if you send your information to the wrong place and someone hacks into your personal device, your Bitcoin is still at risk, your crypto is still at risk. So not necessarily, again, the best place to store it long term. And that takes me to the third type of wallet, hardware wallets. So hardware wallets are where you store your Bitcoin keys on a piece of hardware that has been specifically designed for Bitcoin transactions. And that can include other cryptocurrencies as well, which I'm going to show you in a minute. But this hardware wallet is completely offline to the extent that you would need some type of physical interaction with that hardware wallet, as well as your own private information in order to access it from your personal device. It's not synced up online somewhere where someone can break into it externally. And even if for some reason they hacked into your computer, they wouldn't be able to physically enter in the information they would have to break into that wallet. And it's the safest way to store it. I'm not going to go into paper wallets where you print out a QR code. It's something I typically don't do. I'm not the best organization-wise when it comes to just papers lying around or the mail that I receive. So I tend to stay away from printing things out on paper as if I'm going to put it in my fucking like pristine filing cabinet that doesn't exist for me. But if you're interested in it, there are ways that you can print out QR codes of the keys to make it easier to access it. You would just take a photo of that QR code and it would allow you to get into your wallet. So what are some of the benefits and trade-offs of different Bitcoin wallets? So I talked a little bit about this, so I'm not going to reread it, but if you are online in just an exchange wallet, if they get attacked, your crypto is at risk. If you have it in a software wallet, if you get attacked directly by malware or phishing attack, it's at risk. And then a hardware wallet is the safest way to store it. Now, let me read a little bit more about the different hardware wallets here. Now, I'm going to make two separate suggestions for hardware wallets, and they're two of the most well-known in the crypto space. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to link down below. I'm going to go onto YouTube, and I'm going to find a video of each of them in some other content creator setting them up. Since all my hard wallets are already set up and I already have private information on them, I can't give you a visual. But I'm going to link down below the best video of each wallet being set up, so then you can use that as a good reference instead of trying to hunt down a video on your own to try and follow along and possibly finding one that doesn't represent the proper information. Now, for the first one I'm going to talk about, it is the Trezor wallet. And they have two different main types. They have the Trezor 1 and the Trezor Model T. And I'm going to break down exactly what they look like and how they're set up. But one thing I want to clarify is when you purchase these hard wallets, you have to make sure to order them straight from the actual provider. So whether it's Trezor.io or Ledger.com, when you are ordering your wallet, make sure to get it directly from them. If you go onto Amazon and try and purchase one of these, odds are, if it's an individual seller, there's malware on it. And when you go to put your crypto on it, it will siphon it straight out of your account and straight into someone else's. And there's nothing you're going to be able to do to get that back. And I know people that this has happened to, and it is devastating to see, because you would think, oh, maybe this person online accidentally bought two of them and they're just selling an extra. Never, ever trust a resold Trezor, Ledger, or any other hard wallet. Make sure to buy brand new from the source. So after you get your wallet, it's going to look like one of these two. So this is the Trezor Model T, and this is the Trezor 1 over here. But when you look at some of the things that they're backed by, so you have transparent security. So it's audited by security researchers and verified by a great track record. So Trezor has been around for multiple bull cycles, very, very well-known and involved in the crypto space. This isn't some back-end technology company that just popped out of nowhere. They have great customer support, and they have a very intuitive and convenient interface. And I can speak from my own personal experience with Trezor. I am a massive fan of their wallet, and they do make it very easy to use. Now, when you do set up your wallet, you're gonna see a screen much like this. So you're gonna go in, and they have a very wide array of cryptocurrencies that you can hold on these wallets. Now, the Trezor Model 1, I believe. So the Trezor Model 1 supports less cryptocurrencies. So they're adding some every day, but the Trezor Model T, which is a little bit more expensive, it comes in closer to $150 as opposed to the Trezor one's $50. That one supports many more cryptocurrencies, but they still hold a lot of different cryptos. So you'll be able to see which specific wallet holds which one when you send it back and forth. But once you're in that wallet, it will give you a visual of all the transactions both sent and received to that wallet. And there is a physical punch code on the front of your Trezor. Let me see if I can pull it up here. So it doesn't show it right there, but there are buttons on your Trezor to where you can actually punch in numbers 1 through 9 and they scramble in order to have a secure physical lock code as well, just to access it. So then that way, if someone does hack into your stuff, they still don't have the physical device to punch in those numbers to then enter into the device. But once you're in, you'll be able to see all your cryptos. And when you send it in, it will just store there. You don't do anything with it. You can buy and sell in the hard wallets. I personally don't. Instead, I just use it to store my larger cryptos just to keep them offline and completely out of the fray and hectic nature of this current market. So there is a backup. So if the hardware breaks, you can recover access to all of your coins and assets from your offline backup. It only takes about 5 minutes. And what they have you do when you set it up, and you're going to see in the video I linked down below, you create either a 12 to 24 word long recovery seed. So all it is are just 24 random words in a row that you write down multiple times just to make sure that you have them saved and written down, so that if you ever lose or break your hard wallet, when you go into Trezor's website, you can select recover wallet and type those words in sync in that order, and it will recover your cryptocurrency. Now, a couple important notes about phrase words or recovery seeds, whether it's for hard wallets, soft wallets, or anything in between. Write them down, keep them private, do not show them, do not take photos of them, do not email them to yourself, keep them completely offline. That is a gateway to anyone that understands those words. If they have those words, they can steal your entire crypto bank. So make sure to keep them private and don't share them with anyone. Don't put them online in any capacity. They've been reviewed by many different companies. Jack, the founder of Twitter, Jack Dorsey, he advocates for them. And the Trezor one is the more basic one. And the Trezor Model T is their more premium choice. So it would be completely up to you to jump on to Trezor's website, which I will link down below, and make your own decision as to which model works best for you, or if another wallet works better. The next one I'm going to show, which is the Ledger. So for the Ledger wallet, they are pretty straightforward as well. So be the one in charge of your money, the gateway to buy, exchange, and grow your crypto securely. So they are the world's most quote unquote popular hard wallet. Most people that I know that have hard wallets use Ledger. They have had some issues in the past of people complaining that they got hacked or their stuff was missing. But again, I believe that most of this in any realm, and this is my non-financial advisor personal opinion, I believe a lot of it is personal error. If you do not do this correctly or you're negligent with how you store your private keys or information, you put yourself at risk every single time. And I don't want to see anyone lose any of their crypto just because they weren't being careful. So what you can do on this, again, you can buy, sell, exchange, and manage your crypto, and they have an application you can sync up so you can see all of your information. Now, what is a hardware wallet? They break this down, but I'm gonna read it just for the sake of the video. So to reiterate, a hardware wallet is a cryptocurrency wallet which stores the user's private keys, which is a critical piece of information used to authorize outgoing transactions on the blockchain network in order to secure the hardware device. The main principle behind hardware wallets is to provide full isolation between the private keys and your easy-to-hack computer or smartphone. So think of it as like a wall, blocking anyone that could even hack into your personal devices. It's a wall between those bad actors and your crypto. And then it goes all into the different technology and things like that, but ultimately, it's going to be a little bit out of my realm of expertise. I'm not a coder. I'm also not a security expert. So believe it or not, I can't break down all those specifics. I just know in concept what the hard wallets are used for. But some key takeaways. So the Ledger Live app, it is a great solution to secure, store, and manage your crypto. The Ledger hardware wallets are designed with a high security standard to keep your crypto secure at all time. Ledger Live app is a one-stop shop for your crypto. And again, you can buy, sell, exchange any of the assets with our partners easily and securely. And you can also store a wider range of crypto assets. So the Ledger stores up to 1,800 plus different crypto assets. That's how many it supports, so a very wide array. And the most popular hardware wallets, so more than 2 million units have been sold over the world. And when you have that many individual wallets being sold, you know that they're doing something right. So without just beating the same point into the ground, I'm gonna link both Ledger and Trezor's websites down below. I believe that combined with the videos of how to set them up that I'm also going to tag will be beneficial. And the reason why I wanted to bring this up now is as we start inching closer to past this halfway point in the bull run, crypto is getting more expensive, more new people are coming in. And with new people coming into the space, all the scammers and hackers see is fresh meat to go after because they do not know how to protect themselves and they do not know how to store their crypto safely. So hopefully this information can help you start to get ready to setting up your hard wallet and protecting your cryptocurrency on your journey in this space. And again, if you have any questions, please leave them down below. And if any of the links aren't working for you, just shoot me a message or leave a comment and I'll get you in to the right place. So aside from that, hope you found this helpful. Please subscribe to the channel, share this to whoever needs to see it. As always, I'm honored to have you on today's episode of Viva La Coin, and I will catch you guys next time.